Okay, welcome to the semi-final of the Chess Buddies Challenge. And today I take on I Am Exploring Chess, the international master, Christian Braun. And yeah, I will start again with knight f3, and we'll see. He will go for g6. I kind of anticipated that because he did the same thing versus me recently in some other tournament. So I will just go d4 here, and if he goes bishop g4, I will go bishop b2. If he goes e5, I will just take. He doesn't do that. Okay, he goes for this line, which I have not checked in a long time, so I think he kind of got me here a little bit in the opening. Even though the line is probably supposed to be nothing, I should have checked that one for sure. So he goes knight d4. I'm not sure. So if I, this is the line where I'm supposed to take and go knight d2 and things. Or which line is that? So not exactly sure. Go to take and go queen d3. He will go c5 at some point. So I'm not entirely happy with how the opening went. Can I go queen a4 check here? I think I'll do that. Because if he has to go king f8, then it's fine. And okay, this I don't mind that much. Just go bishop d1 and play for the two bishops. I mean, obviously, in the position after c5, yeah, is pretty double-edged. I have to exchange because I want to blow the position open for my bishops. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, it's just a position. Oh, castle. Shouldn't I play too quickly? Because, I mean, he plays very quickly, and that's it's going to be a major factor in the match for sure, because he's much quicker than I am. Can I go f4? I imagine you can go bishop h6, maybe even. So I don't want to do that, but I also don't really want to go f3 because then he has f4. But maybe that's not so big of a deal. Or I can take and go f4 as well. I'll just go f3 because at least this knight on e7 is quite restricted for the time being. Well, so the opening did not really go according to plan. And I got stuck with this pretty bad bishop on d1. My next plan is definitely to somehow exchange his knight on d4. Yeah, it's a pretty close position. Okay, he goes rook b4. And now I see his idea, which is that if I go b3, we'll go rook b8 with the other rook. And then I probably have to go rook c1. Because he threatens a rook takes c4. Okay, he doesn't do that. So h5. Of course, he wants to go bishop h6 now and pretend that my position of my bishop on e3 is a little bit weakened. But I will still go knight e2, I think. I think knight e2 is useful because this knight on e4 is really a monster. And if I get rid of that one, that would be a big relief, I think. And on top now, a7 is hanging, but maybe he can still go knight e6, bishop a7, and even c5, and followed by rook b7 or rook a8, and he would win my bishop on a7. So I think knight e6 is definitely a little bit unpleasant, but then I would probably go bishop c2. Maybe preparing to go f4 at the right moment. I guess now it's the first time that he also takes his time. But yeah, I think the position is probably still a little bit better for him. But I don't have the feeling that I'm much worse, let's say. Okay. I could go bishop f2, of course. But is it what I want? If I take and go knight e4, then he has bishop e3. If I take and take on d4 and then go bishop c2, That's maybe not pleasant, but it's not the end of the world, I guess. So I will do that. I will take and go knight d4, followed by bishop c2. Then at least there's some pressure on f5. And maybe I have this a3 b4 motifs. So I'm not exactly sure if he's considering to take now on e2. Or what his opinion is about this pawn on d4, but if I was in his shoes, I would just go rook h6, I have to say. Okay, he doesn't do that. I think I should go bishop d3, or can I maybe even go f4 here? f4 looks nice. He can take. Maybe that's a little bit too much. I'll go a3 b4 and just try to slowly make progress. b4 and now next move rook d1, and then maybe c5. So I have to somehow try to prepare c5. That's the key break for me here. The problem with bishop d3 is that he can take, and after bishop takes, he probably has something like d5. And then I don't see how I can make any progress. So now the question is which bishop to take, which rook to take, and usually you should never think too long about this because you always end up taking the wrong one in the end. So it's not advisable to take too long over this decision. Okay, can I go b5 here? Does it make sense? I guess so, yeah. You might go c5 and then try to get his knight over, but I think that's should be fine. Or if I go c5 myself, he will go d5. I can also go a4, intending to go a5. I'll go b5. Oh, but this maybe was not. Oh, but after c5, I have a4. Because I thought after c5 a4 he has king b6, but d6 is still hanging. So after c5 I have a4 a5. Should play a little bit quicker here. As I said, this might be a major problem with this match that he's very quick. I don't think this is worrying me too much. Okay, that's surprising, I have to say. So he gives me that pawn for free. I think I'll snatch it. Okay, he probably wants to go rook b1, rook b1, rook b8. And this seems to work. Wow. I'm surprised that this works, but it seems to work. And if I go bc, that's not really what I want. So I will go rook c1 here. He's never going to take that. So that's okay. So he closes down the position, and now he will try to advance here, but I don't think this is gonna happen. Okay, he will bring his knight eventually somewhere. So to b6, that's well played. I will bring my bishop to b3, because then this bishop has this ideal three square constellation with a knight. I will bring my bishop to b3 and now argue that this position is nothing special. Okay, if he wants to open here, be my friend, be my guest. Don't think I'm terribly afraid of that. Because now I threaten g takes f. After h4 at least. Yeah. So if he goes h5, g takes f. I guess he should somehow regroup his knight to d4. That would be the most unpleasant plan for me. But I'm not sure how he will manage to do that. Okay, after h4, I said I want to go with df. So you have some idea with d3. I think that's too much. G3 takes, takes, takes. I calculated that line. And maybe ended up prematurely. But I thought this would be decent for me. So just take. Okay, now I have to decide whether I want to go king e3, which looks decent, definitely. Or I want to take, in this case, rook h2, king to the first rank, and then both of the minor pieces get under a lot of trouble, so I will just go king e3 here. Okay, now I have to really speed up because I'm behind on the clock again. As in the previous matches, this is a big issue for me. So I'm not used to this super quick online play anymore. Yeah, I definitely have to speed up now. So rook g2 is coming. He can go this knight, but I have f5. I mean, if I get f5 and I have another passed pawn. And yeah, it's a complicated position, definitely. Because this knight is, of course, still much better than my bishop. So I have no clue how to assess the position. Maybe objectively it's better for me, but with this bishop, it's definitely harder to play for me. Yeah, but the f5, the nice thing about f5, though, is that he cannot get his knight to e6 anymore, so I don't have to be afraid that his knight will land on d4 one day anymore. So that's pretty nice. He gives me f5. And otherwise, I mean, I'll get a lot of play against his okay, this one I can definitely not allow him. Maybe he will just go knight c8 or something right now. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I guess his main idea is, yeah, knight d7. Okay, I should probably go back. Maybe this was not accurate because now he has rook h3. Ooh, I think there is a big risk that I will even lose this one. I will bring my bishop to f3. This was the idea. Okay, now he spices things up. Okay, I'll run. I should have gone to e3, definitely. This was a big mistake. Okay. He goes there. I will go here. So maybe one idea I have is rook 7 right now. The idea that this rook is hanging. And yeah, now he will run. The question is, how far can he run? Oh my god. Knight d4 is coming. This is really unnecessary what I did here. Knight d4 is really strong now. I'm afraid. And he instead luckily blunders this one. So, yeah. Oh. Yeah, we actually agreed on giving him a little bit of time to explain what happened in the game for the chess buddies. So he's streaming at the same time. And so I will give him a minute or two to explain his view of the game. But I think it was, the opening didn't go well for me as previously mentioned already. So I think I will go for something else in the next round because I didn't like that opening. So now he's white. I guess he will go e4. I will go with the video in the first game definitely to just see what he intends to do there. I think he will probably be booked up here. But at the same time, this is just a playable position, and I will just go for the same plan that I went for yesterday with this h6, bishop h6, knight h7, knight g5 idea. If he goes knight g3, I might consider to go there. Yeah, I mean, this is just a position, so it's definitely okay for me to just get a playable position out of the opening. Of course, nothing special. But yeah, I could take on I could take and go bishop e6. Guess that's probably what I'll do. And yeah, again, he's pressuring me on time. So this was really what was to be expected, that I would have a hard time competing with him at the clock. So this knight f5, I would just go bishop e5. I mean, strategically, for me, it's okay to exchange this dark squared bishop, because then, I mean, the position should be more or less equal if I manage to do that. So, I mean, knight f5 kind of often looks threatening. But in many cases, you don't have to be too afraid of that. Okay, now he wants to go h4 next. So if I just go king h7, he will go h4. Yes. So if I go g6, if I go g6, what is this idea? He wants to take on e6. G6 takes knight h6. Yeah, that's not working for me. If I take on f5, he has queen f5. I mean, that's not great, but also not the end of the world. So I think, I mean, in principle, I should go for these endgame positions versus him. So I think it's maybe not the worst idea to just do that. Just take this one, take that one, and go queen g5. And I mean, this endgame is not going to be so much worse. Yeah, I guess I'll just take this position. It's probably still slightly better for white. It could also be equal. He brings his king. I guess he wants d4. I will go g6, king g7, f5. And now he simplifies with h4. Ooh, tricky guy. Yeah, I missed this idea. Ooh, this was pretty bad. Because of the king g7, the problem is f7 is hanging. So so I'll go knight a5 here. And if he goes rook h1, I'll just take on b3. And now he definitely has some small advantage, because he has the only open file in this rook ending, and I suspect that should count for something. Mean, the good thing is he cannot really go bishop c2, because then I can go king b7, and then at least I managed to swap down without losing this pawn on f7. So I expect rook ch1, I will take and go king g7. And then he has to go rook h7, king f6. And that's the position we probably will get. Okay, he disagrees. Yeah, I'll just go. Okay, that's maybe very well played. If no, he plays rook h1. Wow. So now he wants to go for this pawn endgame, and that might actually be bad for me. Yeah, very well played on his part. But I have a good idea here. I could go a5, I think. This might give me some counterplay. Because now if he goes rook h7, king f6, I have the idea of going b5, knight d8, knight e6, and then at least having the knight on e6. On top, then he has really weakened his structure. So I guess that's nothing I should be too afraid of if he goes b5 now, because then I have knight e8 and knight to e6. And from e6, I can even kick away his rook from h7, right? So that was actually pretty lucky. I think he played that well, but I was a bit lucky to end up here, I think. And I think maybe this position is perfectly fine for me. Because I'll just go, as I said, I'll go knight e6 next. And then the position should be fine. I could even think about playing a4 here, actually. So, playing a4. A4, bishop c4. Does it, so whom does it favor to do that? I don't know. I'll go a4, just based on intuition. And I don't think that, yeah, maybe even this is not clear, but I don't think bishop e5 is so advisable because I'll then go c6. Now I go knight e6. He can take, of course, and if he doesn't take, I mean, there are a lot of jumps that he has to calculate in the future. So I feel like position should be around equal again. I got a little bit over-optimistic, I think, when in fact the position is probably still around equal. Okay, he doesn't take. So he thinks his bishop is better than my knight. I will go c6. And maybe his idea is to go f4 at some point, but then I have ef, bishop e6, f3 check, king f3, king e6. So yeah. On the plus side, at least now he's for once a little bit down on time compared to me. You know, he wants to go rook b1. That's understandable. I will just go rook b8, I think. Is there any reason to do something else? After rook b8, he wants rook b4, maybe. Yeah, again, pretty tricky way of playing. I will go with this rook to b8. I mean, I'm not too much afraid of this rook on h7. Because I always have counterplay. Okay, he now goes for this move. Then I will just play knight g5. I mean, it's really now the matter of finding the right point to swap rooks for me, I guess. So. Because now he will go f4. Yeah, that was clear. And probably he managed to outplay me here. Yes. Yes, this position is definitely now unpleasant. I could go takes and rook h8. Takes, takes, and rook h8. Because now, I mean, if he wants to take there and swap, then at least I have this annoying rook h3. So this was what I meant by finding the right time to organize some counterplay on the h file. Not sure if this is the perfect time, but okay. I should be able to go d5 at some point. That would be really annoying for him. D5 takes, takes. But it doesn't seem to work here in any way. So I will go rook d8. But then he has e5. Yeah, this is getting really tricky for me. I should play quicker. Play here. And can I now go d5? Takes, takes. Still not really working, so I will go rook d8 now. I'll go rook d8 now. Now I have the idea of going d5, obviously. So I expect e5, but then I have king g7, but it's still very tricky to hold this. The e5, I don't have king f5, I think, because then he has to check here, I think. So king f5 is an option. So check. Okay, he doesn't go for that. So that gives me d5. I have to go here. Oh, wait, no, I have bishop d3. I missed that one as well. So I will go here. I'll go here. Okay, if he goes g5, I can take. I can also now go try to go c5. Can I go g5 on my own? That's very unclear. So I'll go c5. I'm not sure if that's good in any way. I should have gone a3 probably at some point. So yeah, I'm down on time. And the position is very complicated. So I think, but I mean, my king is kind of safe for the time being. Yeah, I should have gone a3. I said that already, I guess. So I'll take. And now I have to see how I can regroup my pieces. Oh, this is really bad. I'm almost in Zugzwang here. We'll go bishop b5, and then I have to run. Run for gold. Run for gold. Let's go. Putting the king on e6 is extremely risky. Okay, he found something which I didn't see. Oh, I cannot play this. I'll give checks. Check. The problem is I can never have knight c6. And now the game is over. I think I'm okay. Okay. Go. 1-1. He managed to strike back immediately. I will now start the next game with g3. And go for the King's Indian. I'll go with a4. It's some line which is not like the main position of the King's Indian. I'll just try to grab some space. And we get another relatively quiet game. Yeah, so the last one I get pretty badly outplayed, to be honest. I thought that I would not lose this position, but he proved me wrong. Can I take and go knight d4? Is that a good option? But I don't even have to do that, right? I can just go knight d2, let's say. Because if he takes, I can just take back with the knight. And now there's again this pressure that he puts on me, right? He plays so quickly. So I'll go bishop e5, trying to provoke him. I guess yes, that's what I'll do. Cause I mean in principle this is his good bishop, even though I mean not this structure here, it's not as clear anymore, but I guess, yeah. Yeah, the second one. Will you go bishop e4 now, maybe? I thought I could take and take here. Because now he cannot take back due to queen d4 check. So I think this was a mistake by him, because now I will get b4 and then I have at least this strong pawn on c5. Yeah, I think that was definitely a mistake. So I should be better now. As discussed, I will go b4. Next move rook d1. And yeah, this position is very pleasant to play, of course, as well. Rook d1, as I said, I mean, it's relatively simple to play this for white for the time being. And he has to face another very unpleasant decision if he wants to go bishop takes f3, or he wants to allow me to go queen h6 and attack him. So could even now go queen h5, queen h6, and then he will probably have to take on f3. Takes, queen f6. though, so I don't really want to give his knight the square on b5. Could also go knight d4. Or, I mean, I could even just go rook c1. Maybe that's actually not so bad to just go rook c1. But he might go b6 at some point. Yes, okay. So I have to calm down a little bit. Could also go knight e5. Yeah, I'm not sure. I'm not really sure. So I think queen h6 should be the right move. And I'm basically forcing him to take on f3. And now he goes queen f6, as I said. And I will just play this move. And after knight b5, I guess one idea could be to go just go queen f4. Okay, also here one idea could be to go queen f4 to fix the structure. The other one is to go rook d4, rook h4. He has e5, rook h4, queen g7. And I don't know if I want that, so I will just go queen f4. Trying to fix the structure. I mean, he can go queen e7, of course. In that case, I would maybe just play e3 and claim that he doesn't have any counterplay against c3 anymore. So, or I could go e4, but then after e5, queen e3. I don't like e4 because he gets d4, so I'll just go e3. So I should be a bit careful not to get my queen trapped on f4. So I guess next move I will. Okay, that's a little bit unexpected. Okay, not sure what he wants there. I will even go here to prepare c4. I mean, my idea is to go c4 at some point. If we go f5, I guess I can already go c4. Now he protects against c4 because then he can go d4. Yeah, he plays this very well, I have to say. Again, I mean, that's pretty annoying. Can go a6. I'll go h4. Be a bit careful not to get my queen trapped. That's still the case. So yeah, no, I'm not sure about the position. I mean, should be better, but it's not easy to play. It's not easy to play at all because he will go. But if he goes queen f6, then I have bishop g4. So my plan could be to go rook d2, rook d1 now. Yeah, another very tough game, definitely. It's a very, very even match so far, which is what I expected because he's extremely strong in blitz, especially in online blitz as well. Will he go f5? That's maybe another question. Will he go f5? Because this is kind of like the point of no return if you go f5. Okay, after queen f6, I said I wanted to go for bishop g4, I think. So I will also do that. And I'm not so sure if he wants to swap the bishop against the knight, especially if I get queen f4 in afterwards. So then he's just in a rook in an endgame with his material down. Yeah, so as I said, he doesn't want that. He goes back. And now could again go queen f4. Offer him the same kind of ending, and he will again run away from that. So now I have at least h5. Making it a bit less attractive for him to go f5. Because then his king is also very open. Not saying it's bad, it could be even that it's good, but it's not an easy move to make. And another point to consider here is that if he goes f5, knight e6, I have this square on e5 for my queen. So, yeah, let's see. But I also don't think he wants to wait passively. So then we get h6 in. Not sure even if I go h6 immediately. Or maybe first bishop e2. Okay, now he suddenly wants to exchange. That doesn't make so much sense to me. So I'll just go queen f6, I think. I will go queen f6. If he takes, I'll just take back. Even though there might be stronger options on the table. Okay, he now allows me to exchange queens, which in principle should be good, but I could even consider to go transom. I'll just take it and go bishop e2 to now go c4 next. Yeah, I'll go c4. Can I go b5? I think so, yeah. So he allowed me to go b5. I think this was definitely a mistake. Because after d takes c, I can take back with check. And then I can either go b6 or, I mean, this position is now bad, huh? Okay, this was his idea. But how does he want to take back here? He doesn't want to give me all the free pawns. The passed pawns. So, could think about going b takes c. Could also think about going bishop c4. Bishop c4, though, runs into these shenanigans. So I will go with b6 here. Okay, I should play a bit quicker. Okay, let's go b takes c. I'll go b6. Okay, b6. I have to play more quickly. That's definitely definitely true. He will probably go knight b4 at some point. Doesn't go knight b4 immediately, which is a bit of a surprise. Can I go for bishop c4? Takes. I'll just go for bishop c4. Takes, and bishop d5 is coming. Okay, but that ending should be horrible for him. Because now, I mean, I will just wait, I guess, bring my king. Okay, he locks down everything, hoping for complete lockdown, but I will go with my king now to b4. I think this is the next step, and then I will improve my rook to the d file again. So I'll go queen, king b3, and now, as I said, bring my rook to the d file. Yeah, no, I think he gave me this one. So okay, rematch. Yeah, now it's 2-1. Okay, he goes for e4 again. I will go for knight f6 this time. this is now a double filly lure. I like it a lot. it's a very symmetric position. So I think we both don't really want to fight each other in the opening, which is fun. Yeah, I shouldn't play too quickly. Again, that's my major mistake that I did in some of the games, I think, so far. So I should try to reroute this knight to e6. Did I allow him to go d4 now? Is it good? I don't know. Then we get a kind of a King's Indian position with a pawn on c2. Yeah, it's a very, very close match, that's for sure. He goes for a slower setup. Yeah, he goes with his knight to e3 finally as well. And I'll go b5. Again, I allowed d4 now. Yeah, so I'm a little bit careless with these things. I again walked into something here which I should not have done. So can I go b5? D takes e, b takes c, takes takes. d6 is hanging. But it also looks like I get a lot of counterplay there. So definitely one option to go e takes d right now. E takes d, knight takes, d5. If I go d5, takes, this is another one of these very complex positions. I guess I'll go d5. I'll go d5, no matter what. Okay. I mean, maybe that's not good, but it's definitely forcing matters here. And I should not fall behind on time too much. So, I mean, he can now go, of course, go. Go e takes d. Guess my idea was to take back with the knight. And then knight e6, bishop e6, bishop g7, queen d4 check, queen f6. Yeah, I'll take back with the knight. As I said, takes, takes. Bishop g7, king g7. Queen d4 check, queen f6. So I think I don't see anything immediate. I mean, obviously he's slightly bit better here, I would guess. Yeah. The other question he of course has to ask himself is if he has to take on e6. So what happens if he does something else? He could, for instance, play bishop takes d5. Yeah, I missed this move in advance. I'm also not sure if it's good. Okay, his idea is to go queen d5, knight, queen d5, knight b6. And if I then go and pick up the knight on d4, it's probably too slow, yeah? I don't really want to play c takes d, but I guess I'm almost forced to do that, so I'll do it now. Okay, can I maybe even play f takes e here? That looks a bit weird. But it's not out of the question. But I think I'll stick to bishop takes e because h3 is hanging. Ah, I think we both missed that. So h3 is hanging, so maybe he... How about if he goes knight e3, I have d4, so then position is also fine. So I guess queen d4 check, queen f6 is what we're going to see. And then h3 is still hanging. Yeah, I think that went okay-ish. So knight e3, I have d4. And knight g4, then I could even go h5. Because queen d4, or queen f6, I guess. And now he probably has some idea. Like bishop h3, and then to go g4, is that his idea? So first go rook c8 in any case. That's an easy move to make. And yeah, now could think about going rook c3. It's probably not what he anticipates, so I will do that to get him thinking. Because next move I will go rook c8. And then c2 is hanging, and he cannot play rook e2 because of rook b3. And h3 is still kind of loose. So, I mean, I didn't take it because of g4, but especially with the rook on c3, I'm not sure that I cannot take it in one of the next moves. So, yeah, I'll go rook c8 next. I think now I like my position. I should definitely be better here, but of course it's far from over, especially with these knights and blitz. It's always always a nuisance. The good thing is knight f3 is not working because obviously the f3 square is protected. Okay, he goes for the pure rook ending. And if I go back, he has knight e3, but I don't think that changes so much, to be honest. Can take on g4, h takes, rook c8, rook d1. Yeah, I don't think I want to go there, so I will go here. And now just rook c8 next, and after knight e3, then I have d4. So one good move could be rook ed1 now. Okay, place rook e3. That's a little bit of a weird move. Could go d4, which looks good. Definitely looks good. But he can take and go rook d1 maybe. Yeah, so maybe rook c8 now. I will go rook c8 now to just keep the pressure. Yeah, it's getting into a complex endgame again. And we are both pretty low on time already, which is not good for me. Okay, he has probably some idea. I said he has knight d1. That is idea. Yeah, but then I can go back with the rook and take on b3 next. Yeah. And h3 is also still hanging. So if he goes b4, which I think is what he should do, then I could either take and go bishop b3, which looks very strong to be honest. Or I could take on h3. So I think especially his knight on d1 is of course now a pretty bad piece. So he could go c4 though. I missed this one of course as well. And then I can go dc. Takes. But this ending should be winning for me. So after c4 I will just go dc. Because this endgame seems to be winning. Otherwise b3 is hanging. So after c4 as I said I'll just go dc. Because I thought that this ending is winning for me. Unless he has something very quick. I mean, if I get bishop c4 and b5, it's over. I'm pretty sure about that. So I'll go bishop c4. As I said, now b5 b4. Oh my god, I'm so stupid. I mean, this is incredible. I missed that. I mean, should still. Doing okay, but this was of course completely unnecessary. This was completely unnecessary. I run over. So he has no immediate play against these pawns. This is intriguing. Can he go king e5 at some point though? I don't think so, so I'll just go b5. I don't think he has that much play against the pawns, to be honest, so I will just go. Go h5, yeah. I mean, very tough game. Very, very tough game. If he goes king e5, if he goes f5, I wanted to take and put my bishop on g6 eventually. So I think this is now full on swindle mode, which he plays now. He wants to go for knight e7 check. Can I go? Ah, but he has knight f6. Then I should be two. Okay, I'll go. King d6, knight f6. Oh, he has knight f4. Wow. I go a4. Let's see. And now I will take and go f4. I'll go f3. Okay, I can't go f2. Careful, because of h6. I'll still go f2. I mean, at least I have a draw in hand then. Which is better than nothing. Yeah, I mean, that was pretty insane. At the end, I was afraid of getting flagged, so I really botched that one up. I mean, pretty clear that he should not have gotten away with a draw here. Maybe he'll go e5 now. I mean, no. He wants to repeat that line. I will do that. So let's see. We will play the same line again. He goes knight c6 this time, preparing e5, I guess. And what do I want to do after e5? I think I should ask myself this question. Do I want to take? And if so, what is the best preparatory move to take? It's probably knight c3. Knight c3 takes, takes, bishop g5. Yeah, that's tough. That's tough. I guess e5 takes takes. I'll go knight c3 and take on e5 and goes e5. I mean, I don't particularly mind playing endgames, even though I misplayed this last one. I think in principle this is where my edge on him should be if I have one. You go. I go e4, he'll go e5, and then I have cut down this beautiful bishop from the diagonal. But on the other hand, this bishop is also cut, so I will go e4. Will you go bishop g4 now? That would be his style, so I didn't see that coming, but that would really be his style, so I guess he will go bishop g4 now. Yeah, as I said, that would really be to his liking. I knew that. I will still go h3. Of course, now he goes e5. One option is to take and go knight d5. I think I should not go into the closed positions after d5. Why not, actually? Why not? D5, knight e7. And it will take him a long time to do anything. So after d5, knight, knight e4, bishop e7, sorry, d5, knight d4, bishop e3, knight d7. I will get knight e2 in at some point. So I think that's also okay. I mean, if I take, take, and go knight d5, he can take, and go knight d4. So I think I'll just play it in this way with bishop e3 next. Or do I want to save my bishop? Another difficult decision. So it's another very, very difficult game to play. And I mean, it's pretty obvious we are even in terms of strength in this match. And it will come down to details. I mean, I guess one thing about knight d4 which he doesn't like is the fact that the knight is kind of trapped on d4. So then I can go back to d2 and maybe go with my bishop somewhere, just as I'm saying that he plays knight d4, of course. If I go bishop e3, he can take, take. I'll do that. I think, I mean, it's a bishop, but it's not the best bishop on earth, so why not to give it away and in principle play against his bad bishop on g7. So I'm not sure if I'm threatening anything right now, because if I take and take then on d4, he has knight takes e4, so I don't think I'm threatening anything, but he also needs to find a plan. Oh. Taking a little bit too much time in the opening again. I will go bishop g2 next, so this is definitely the idea. Okay, we play c5. Which I'm not sure I'm a fan of that move, because I guess I will just go bishop g2 now. And play against this knight on d4. Maybe knight b1 could be next, followed by c3, and bring the knight to c4. And I don't think he's in time to open up the king side. So as I said, I'll just go knight b1 next, and go c3 next, and then bring my bishop and my knight to c4. I mean, does he really want to go f5 here? I don't know. Maybe he does, but I'm not terribly afraid of that. Especially. Okay, knight c4, as I said. I think this is a little weakening what he does there, to be honest. So I think now, in principle, I should probably be better. But of course, it's difficult to play. I think he will have to go for f5 at some point. Knight a5. I'll just go c3. So yeah, well, that's it's another complex one. So I have to now find good squares for my pieces. I'll go queen e2. Does he want to go c4? don't know. I don't think so. So I'll just go queen e2, and I mean his pieces are not really doing that much on the queen side. So I will eventually go f4. That's of course the idea now, and eventually might even be here. But maybe that's a little bit too premature. So I will just go king h2 first. Can I do anything on the queen side? That is another question which is intriguing me. So I could go knight c6, which seems decent enough. After f5, I wanted to go f4. What do I have to take? Take an f4. I think I'll go f4 straight away. Because, I mean, his knights are not really playing, so if he now opens up the position. That should not be too worrying for me, I thought. Unless it works in some concrete way for him. I could go knight c4. Which might threaten to go. Oh, but that's too complex. I should try to keep it simple. I don't have much time anymore. I should go queen c2 and just take back with the bishop. He can take, go queen e7, but I have rook e1. Yeah, he will just make some waiting move. I'll go back with the bishop, intending to go rook e1 next. So, I might go queen e7 now, though. And then I'll probably go knight c6. But that's a little bit too unclear for my liking. Still, I guess I have to do it. So, queen e7 looks like a strong move. I could go queen d2, queen e2, rook e1 then. Okay, do that. So he lets me enter on c6. Maybe actually knight c4 was stronger. With a similar plan. I mean a6 is hanging now anyways. So that's a bit unpleasant for him. Yeah, as I said. Okay, now I will go rook e1 and go rook e7 next. Okay, he doesn't allow me to do that, of course. So I will take the other rook. I learned from that. So let's see. I threaten rook e7. And now he defends more passively. After rook e6, yes, knight f8. I'll still go for that and go back to e2. And now go for rook e1. Followed by rook e7. Yes, rook f4 now. I missed. Not sure if it's good. Should probably pre-move that one. Okay. Take here. Take this one. Do I have something tricky here? Probably I do, but I don't see it. And now it's the region again where he's quicker than me, so I have to be careful. I'll go rook e7, but I have bishop g5 then. And if he has knight f3, I can take and meet him. So now I'll go here and threaten bishop f6. I'll go bishop h6 next. How about the pure endgame? As easy as I thought. Yeah, he challenges me to go for that. This was definitely a big mistake by me. And now I might even lose this game. But I have this move, which could be a bit annoying. Okay. Okay, what does he think about? B5 takes, takes. Oh, no, I can take here actually. I'll take there. And go d7 in case it goes knight e3. Okay, so d7 and I think it's over. Yeah. Well, I think now it's 3.5 to 1.5, if I count correctly, but we're still playing the sixth game. Let me go for something else now. Okay, he goes for the Italian game. That was a close match, definitely. So what is this? This is some old trickery, or what? What is this? I mean, I think this is some theory, but I don't think it's particularly good for White. I'm a little bit surprised that he goes for that. I think one can even go knight, queen f6 here immediately, but that's b6 is also fine. This is some old game from Vishy Anand versus some kind of computer, I think. This could still be theory, by the way. Yeah. I mean, it's a little bit different now when you play a game which is not counting anymore towards the end result, but yeah, this match was very tough, definitely. So it was definitely also tougher than the other two so far. Yeah, now you see that we both play much quicker, so it's also obvious that this game is not as important to either one of us anymore. Bishop d3, I guess. Takes, takes. Knight d6. Goes knight d6 immediately. This is plan, and I have to just take back. Knight e8. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Amazing. I didn't see that coming. Oh, I just blundered a rook now. Yeah, GG. Yes. Is there anything that could save me? No, I don't think so. So, yeah, very close match. Fortunately, I won 3.5 to 2.5. And thanks a lot for watching. See you for the final.